two ways of launching a vessel adhesion. The first way is in a dry dock. Then we just fill the dry dock with water, and the water level gently rises and the boat starts to float. And the other way is a bit more complicated. It's from a slipway. Then we work with train wheels, where we drive the yacht down the slipway into the water. We are still using a slipway only in hole number one. It's something that remained from the start of Heesen, when we only had slipways. But Project Octopussy was built in shed number one. But at the moment we are growing over the size where it's still possible to do this. Let me take you through the process of a slipway launch. The first stage is where we lift the vessel up and place her on two carriages on train wheels. The second stage is where we start moving the vessel down along the train tracks. Step number three, it gets more interesting, because then we start to displace water with the yacht. Project Jade is a special launch, because the load on the aft carriage is higher than what the carriages can handle. So we needed to invent something to enlighten the load on the aft carriage. Therefore we have two skids along the train tracks, which support 120 ton of the load on the aft carriage to enlighten the load on the train wheels. And that works until the aft side of the boat is in the open air outside. There the load of the skids is taken over by a heavy crane. Step number four is when the aft part of the yacht starts to float, so it's not touching the aft carriage anymore. At most yachts, also at Jade, there we get a negative stability. That means that the yacht wants to capsize, but it doesn't, because it's still lying on the front carriage. Step number five, the forward carriage is low enough, so the yacht is getting more horizontal in the water, and then the negative stability phase is over. Then we can start breathing again, and then it's just lowering the front end as well, and then the yacht is totally afloat.
An inclination test is a way to determine the weight of the vessel and the center of gravity of the vessel. We use for the stability calculations afterwards. We need to do an inclination test for FLEC to certify the vessel. Yeah, we start with some weights on the boat and on both sides of the boat. That's the zero shift. In total we have 8 shifts. We're gonna shift the weights from one side to another. We also add pendula in the top of the mast, and then we can show the deflection of the boat when we shift the weights. We know how much weight we shifted, and we know what the distance is that we are shifting that the weights, and then we can calculate the total weight and the center of gravity of the vessel. The vessel performed as expected and well within our margins.